Today, our speaker, Teri Freesmeyer, intuitive healer, consulting hypnotist, shamanic minister, is a certified metaphysician for over 25 years of experience in the healing arts. She works with the energy medicine field, spiritual coaching, shamanic studies, and sound healing. Teri's gift of communicating with the divine spirit realms and sensing vibrational energy helps her to customize each session or event uniquely. Teri's been a guest speaker and keynote for the UU Women's Connection. Along with her private practice, she enjoys sharing her transformational energy toolbox at seminars, conferences, and retreats around the country. She recently returned from Boston, where she co-presented a class at the National Guild of Hypnotists on supernova hypnosis for health, weight, and body image. Her goal is to bring a sense of fun, inspiration, and new perspectives to this often serious game of life.
Good morning, and thank you for all who made this opportunity possible. I'm really excited to be here. Can you hear me okay? Okay. I just ask you all to let's just take a nice deep breath in together. And as we release that breath with sound, so deep breath in. All right. So I started to make a list about all the things that distract me from creating and manifesting and being connected with my greater essential self. And one of the things on that list was making lists. I did recognize that. And oftentimes, just not knowing what I want. What do I want to create? What is it that I want? Or I know what I don't want. Anybody else have that? Well, I know what I don't want, but what do I want? And the other piece is that on the top of that list was letting my ego mind rule over my heart. And so then the logic starts, the fear starts, the confusion starts, and so forth. And so I'd like to share with you today a couple of experiences, experiential experiences. Anybody have a challenge with resistance? Is it just me? Okay, good. All right. Resistance has really been a great teacher for me recently, and I've learned with resistance to start listening to my body and how it feels when I'm in that space of resistance. Sometimes it's telling me, no, that isn't right for me. Or no, that's not quite true for me. And sometimes it's telling me fear or warning or pause. Maybe it's not time to make a decision yet. And sometimes it's downright stubbornness and self-sabotage. You know, and I'm sure of many other things, but I've learned a lot about resistance. And one of the things that I recognize is we are often plugged into no throughout our life. No, resistance, stopping. And it's our natural fight or flight instincts as humans to have that created glitch in our manifesting possibilities. So today I'd like to teach you how to find your yes, how to plug into that yes. And so take a deep breath with me again. So even though you may not know or may not believe that there's a part of you that already does know what is right alignment for you, what is true, right, and good for you right now, can we agree on that? And take a deep breath and just begin to consider what you want for your life, what you want for your community, what you want for your world. Abundant health, wealth, love, peace. Just let that run through there for a moment. And then I would like you to bring your hand to your heart, to your physical heart, as if you were just touching that physical, beating, rhythmic space. And you may want to close your eyes and just tune into that space in your heart. And breathe into this heart, away from your head for a moment. Touch it, feel it. Feel that beating rhythm of your heart. And imagine the cells of your heart just waiting to enliven your heart's desire. Whether that's personally, worldly, divinely, to ignite your passion, Sense into this divine, intelligent heart and just take a breath there. And we're asking this heart, this divinely intelligent heart, to help us align with our yes. Yes, this is true for me. Yes, this is good for me now. Yes, this is the right choice. You may not know exactly what you wish to manifest or create or how to get there even, but don't concern yourself with that right now. Finding what yes is for you, feeling that into the body, because this is our connection to the physical world, manifesting in the physical world, this body. Finding that yes in your own space. The what's will come easier, and the how's will be the response of the universe. We often say, or I often say, I want X, Y, Z, but then all of the doubt and the conflict starts. But what if this happens? What if that happens? And so that's not in alignment with that. Yes, to just allow the flow to happen. So take a breath into that heart. This treasure chest of manifesting power and unlimited potential. This creative vessel right here in your chest, right here in your heart, that flows information through your whole body. Ask this wise, intelligent part of you to help you feel or sense in some way what yes, true, this is right for me, feels like to you today. What does that feel like in your body? What is yes, this is true? Is there a blossoming, an opening, a freedom? Is there a lightness? Maybe there's emotion. And we want to connect this with our body because that's where our heart's desires can manifest, this three-dimensional world. When we align that in our body, our energy is in alignment with what we want. Even if what we just want is to turn on that yes. If we're all walking around in no, we're all walking around in resistance and discord. So even though we may have an opinion about something, we can be in our yes. So take a deep breath in. Sometimes we have to start with our no before we can find our yes. So you might ask, what does the no feel like? Does it churn up the gut? Does it clench? Does it feel tight in the jaw? Notice what no feels like. And take a deep breath. And go back to your yes. Always turn back on your yes. Start your day with yes. That could be a little song. Start your day. Can you work on that? Okay, thanks. And as you tune into that yes, letting that yes blossom. And even though you might not know what you want to create, just turning on your yes allows that flow of creativity to start flowing. It starts bringing things to you. The universe starts showing up in certain ways, and you can say, yeah, that's the direction I want to go, or wow, I hadn't even thought about that, but that feels really good to me. Do you know what I mean? Okay. So I'd like to do a little group manifesting today. Would you join me on that? So tune into your yes. And you may have some goals floating through there. And let me give you a hint. When you're making those goals, make them big, juicy, and specific. I like to say juicy because to me, juicy goals say there is joy involved. There is bigger potential than what I first may have thought of involved. So I let it be juicy. Don't concern yourself with the details of how it can happen because the mind will send you out on that rat race. But focus on your heart. Focus on that connection in your heart. And breathe into that space where you find your yes. And notice how it can flow out through your whole body. So I'd like to invite you all to focus on your yes. And let's create a wave of appreciation, love, and healing to the earth. Now here's where that specific piece comes for you. you might tune in specifically to the trees, or to the water, or to your family, or to your loved ones, or to those people in Africa that are in a crisis, to the people in our country who are experiencing crisis. It may be to your community. Find your specific that you want to focus on, because together we can create a really big impact, a wave of vibrational energy into all these places, sitting right here together in community. So I'll give you a moment to just find your specific, your juicy, that personal piece for you, and find your yes. You'll feel it. Is that what I'm focusing on today? Find that yes. And then bring any images of that. The trees, the earth itself, communities. And we're going to use a powerful healing technique today that you all brought with you. Our voice. We're going to use our own sound vibration to create that wave of energy and feel it in our physical self, which plants it in this physical plane. Are you ready? Are you ready? Okay, there we go. All right, yes, yes, okay. So we'll be able to create this powerful, potent piece of energy, and then you'll be able to do this for your own personal goals when you leave here. So we're just gonna take a moment and connect with that heart and bring that image and feeling of what you would like to create with this powerful blast of energy. And then I want you to just imagine that you're just planting a seed here in your heart. And as we sound this tone together, imagine it moving out through your roots and down into the earth. Can you do that with me? We're going to sound to the word bloom, focusing on the vowels. So, bloom. Are you ready? Are you ready? Yes. Okay. Finding that image, those feelings, that yes for you. Take a deep breath in. Bloom. Imagining that vibrational energy just moving out through the roots into the earth. Then bring your hand to your heart and one to that emotional gut somewhere where you feel that stirring of emotion. We want to generate an emotional cadence of awe. And we're going to use the word wow. Okay? Tuning into those feelings. Deep breath in. Wow. To your core, connecting with your core somewhere in here. That place of intense personal power and light, fire, flame, passion. That you know that whatever you could imagine, there could be something even bigger and greater than what we could think of, correct? So tuning into that space, we want to say, whoa! Okay, are you ready? Whoa. Deep breath in. Whoa! Wonderful. And connecting again to that heart, that center space between the heavens and the earth. Knowing there's a grace, a greater essence that has lifted our intent to a new level of existence. Deep breath in. Feel that just cradle around you, around us, around the earth. Around those specific, juicy, personal pieces that you're holding space for. And as we bring our voice even fuller, we're going to sound to that word, true. Knowing we have the power and potential to create this space right here, and together we are impacting that even greater. Just through our intent. Just through our intent. Without distraction of how to get there. or what can I do, or I don't know how. So breathing in into that space of that manifesting heart, speaking it into your yes and your true, deep breath in, true. That we all flow with this greater essence. We all are part of this greater essence, even if we may not know exactly what that may mean in each moment. And coming to the space in the brow, the space where we visualize, we imagine. And we want to impart that space of celebration as if it is already so. What we've held our intent for, what we've sound vibrated out into the universe. So even though our physical ears can no longer hear it, it's still going. It's still rippling. It's still moving. It's still affecting our body. You might even feel some vibration in your body. You might feel some lightness moving. You might feel your circulation improved, your breath deeper, your voice sounding really great today. Yes. Okay. Deep breath in. Yippee! And as we move into the space of meditation, where we can just sit with this space that we've created, we can sit in that harmony of those vibrations, in that space of, yes, this is what I could do today. This is what I can offer in this moment. This is my yes. I want to thank you for letting me share this with you, for being a part of it, because I know, even though I may not know how that's looking, I know we've just created a really powerful impact in all of those places that have touched our hearts individually and then collectively. I like to imagine shooting a rocket up into that collective consciousness and just love, healing, and appreciation for recognizing we have this innate peace within us to guide us to that next right step, that true. And so as you close your eyes, I would like you to take a deep breath in and sound your yes into silence, into meditation. Deep breath in. Yes. Thank you.
I close this morning with one of my favorite benedictions. Go your ways, not knowing the answer to all things, yet seeking always the answer to one more thing than you know.